What you are looking at are my recent site analysis boards for my thesis. In this video, we are going to see how to make 3D contour lines in top view. What's going on, fellas? I'm Geo and this is Geo Creations. You can find me on Instagram as GeoJerwin. Let's jump right into the video. First, let's see why this kind of presentation is important, or why do you even care about this in the first place? Well, the main objective of a presentation is to draw attention to your subject and to reduce effort put by the viewer or your juror, because they may already be tired of seeing repeated stuff over and over again. Here, these lines give the spectator a 3D perspective without you rotating your site in 3D axis. This makes your presentation a lot easier to look at. There are a lot more presentation techniques you can include in your site analysis. If you want a part 2 covering those details, leave a comment below. And before getting into the topic, consider joining this community by subscribing to the channel for new architecture content every Wednesdays. Alright, let's start with extracting contour lines. There are many ways to do this. What I use to extract contours is SketchUp. Let me show you how to do it. Let's open SketchUp. We're gonna use the location toolbar here. If you don't have this, right click over here and turn on the location. Now you can see the location toolbar. Click on the add location icon. Select your location and import it into your model. You can turn on or off 3D terrain using this button. Now let's extract the contour lines from this. Draw a rectangle on the C-plane and make it as a group. Make sure that it's slightly below the lowest part of the terrain. Now copy the rectangle along the blue axis. The interval between them is your contour interval. Here it's 1 meter. To do multiple copies at once, you need to copy it once, type an asterisk and type the number of copies you want. For instance, let's type 50. Erase the copies which are above the terrain. Now we need to intersect these rectangles with the terrain. To do that, select all of them, right click and select intersect with model. Now delete those rectangles and you are left with the contour lines you want. Let's select them and move aside. Now let's export them as PDF. Before that, we need to set a view showing the contour in top view. Go to the camera and select parallel projection to remove perspective. After that, we need to set the view parallel to the Z-plane. For that, again, go to camera, standard views and select top view. Now go to file, export, 2D graphic, let's save them as PDF. Now we got the contours as separate vectors. Turn off the terrain and draw your site boundary. You need a plugin called Bezier Curve to draw splines seamlessly, or you can use AutoCAD to do this step. And if you want my plugin collection, just leave a DM on my Instagram. Now let's export this as PDF, as we did for the contours. Now let's bring both of them and align them. Select both the layers and convert them into a smart object so that you can edit it later by double-clicking on the layer's thumbnail. Let's assign textures to the site. Let's turn off the contour layers for now. Bring the textures you want. hide it for now. Select the part you want to assign the texture. Now turn the material layer back on and click the mask button. Unlink the clipping mask so that you can move your texture around. As you can see, this is a water body and which is a little bit below the ground level, so let's give it some shadows. Double click on the layer and the layer style dialog box will appear. Now select the inner shadow and adjust its size. For this site, I've used different kinds of brushes to give it some sort of a rough terrain look. Now it's time to give the shadow effect to the contours. Let's turn on the contour layers, bring that on top and create a new layer. Now select a single contour. Let's start from the top. Select this contour and invert the selection by pressing Ctrl Shift plus I. Now take a soft brush, increase the size, reduce the flow, and start painting around the edges. Here I'm not using the drop shadow layer style because I wanted it to be somewhat imperfect because it's an imperfect terrain and also it gives a human touch. I'm using a pen tablet to do this kind of stuff, which is a lot quicker and allows you to control the flow by inducing pressure. Repeat the same to every successive contour. Here I've done it only on the side and just gave alternative colors for the contours outside the site. You can experiment with it and come up with your own style. As you made this far in this video, I'm assuming you might have learned something new today. If so, leave a like and tell in the comments if you want me to cover more on site analysis. And most of you that watched my video aren't subscribed, so do it. It's free. Catch you guys in the next video. See ya.